Now, KSBW Weather Plus.
This is Phil Freeman for Carl Thormeyer. This is the view of our KSBW Weather Plus LiveNet stations. And we are seeing temperatures warm up a little bit in Santa Cruz, but we're still in the 30s, the upper 30s in Hollister and King City. Clouds are increasing. We're starting to see the winds increase a little bit, especially up to the north, as we do have an approaching cold front. Now, here's the larger view of the temperatures. San Jose is getting the southeast winds, which is the rain wind. They're at 46 degrees right now, but then you go all the way down to the south to Paso Robles. They're getting a temperature right now of 38 degrees, and everybody else in between. This is rather cool for a cloudy morning in April. And the reason why is because we had this cold front move through. It was really weak yesterday. Gave us some clouds, didn't give us any rainfall, but it gave us another shot of cold air. And now we're looking at this system right here, and we have the low pressure area right there, and then we have the associated cold front tailing out of it. This is moving toward us, and this is going to give us quite a weather event, at least for a few hours later this afternoon and evening. In fact, the National Weather Service has issued warnings. This red is a winter storm warning for the Sierra and even into much of the coast range north of San Francisco. That is a little bit unusual for this time of the year. And the reason why is because the jet stream is moving right through the area. It's going to continue to push southward, and we are still in the midst of the cold air. In fact, you can see this model is showing the heaviest rain at around 10 p.m., and behind that is northwesterly flow, and that's going to be the story for later tonight and on Monday when we start to see the skies clear and we get those northwest winds, and it'll turn out to be a beautiful day, but we may have some lingering showers. High pressure is going to try and build in. Wednesday looks to be the warmest day, but then you can see that the ridge kind of flattens out. And the long-range models past Thursday are calling for the jet stream to dip southward once again and give us a threat of rainfall on Saturday. Here's the microcast wind and rain forecast, and you can see we expect the rain to start at around 1:30 p.m. most areas, but the real peak rain will be with the frontal passage, and here you can see the frontal passage, strong southerly winds right ahead of it, and then westerly winds behind it with heavy rain. That's why the National Weather Service has issued a small craft advisory for the Monterey Bay this afternoon and evening. We're looking at southerly winds getting up to 25 knots. So maybe not a great day to go fishing, but the weather should improve tomorrow because we'll get more northwest winds and they'll be a lot lighter by tomorrow afternoon and evening. You can also see some clearing around the San Francisco Bay Area. So if you are going to San Francisco today, though, you can expect it to be cloudy and rainy later today with highs only in the 50s. And for the Santa Clara Valley, pretty much the same forecast. Cloudy and rainy, highs only in the 50s. And for the Salinas Valley, cloudy and rainy, highs in the mid-50s to low 60s. These temperatures are like January rather than April. And the same forecast is true for the Monterey Bay Area. And another chilly day in the Santa Cruz County area with rain developing could get around 2 inches in parts of the Santa Cruz Mountains. And then the rain should turn to showers tonight, decreasing showers on Monday with bits of sunshine. And then we start to warm up a little bit.
Right, throughout the way. And then maybe some rain next Saturday.
Maybe some more rain Saturday. We are still in the rainy season, although we're getting toward the end of it.
Right.
So we can still get rain.
All right, very good. Thank you, Phil.
Thanks.